Hi friends, do you want to lock a folder using the command prompt? So you can easily do it. Okay, what you have to be do, you have to be just right click on the start menu, then select the option command prompt as a admin, click on yes. Okay, if I open my drive, currently in my E drive, as you seen here, I have no any folder. Okay, so I'm going to create one folder, or you can also use your existing folder also for this to lock a folder this purpose. Okay, to now you need to be switched to the E directory, so just enter the E and then slash. Okay, then after just press enter. Okay, as you seen here, now you are in the E directory. Okay, so now I'm going to create one folder, let's say. Then you have to be enter the command mkdir, means you are going to create one directory making. So this one I'm going to see the name, take the name Rumi test. Okay, just press enter. Okay, if we will go for the, as you seen here, now we have one folder Rumi test. We have this folder Rumi test. Okay, and now I'm going to lock this one. So what you have to be do, you have to enter the command cacls. Okay, then after your path, whatever path you have for your folder. Okay, I have Rumi test in E directory, and then after for slash E slash P, and if you want to do for the everyone, so enter the command everyone. Okay, and SAN for no. Okay, so this will be your command, complete command. Okay, here if you have any other directory or any folder, so if you have the C drive, so it will be C in your folder name. And here if you don't want to give the permission to everyone, so you can also give to the users. Okay, press enter. Okay, now we will go for the folder. Okay, as you seen here, you don't have currently permission to open this folder, because currently I also don't have, because I put it the everyone. Okay, so if you click on the continue. Okay, you have been denied to permission to access this folder, so you have to go for the security tab, and then after you are able to take the rights, then it will comes. So maybe you are thinking how it's effective for you. Suppose you have the 4 or 5 users in your PC. Okay, and you wants to just not, you don't want to give the permission to another one user on the particular folder, so it's too effective. Okay, so like, see, suppose to see how many users we have, open the run menu with and enter the command cmd. okay, and then after you have to be enter the command net user to view available users. Okay, as you seen here, I have user Rumi IT tips and Rumi test. Okay, so if I want to deny the permission for Rumi test, means particular folder is not, means the contents whatever I have, it's not going to be visible for the Rumi test. Okay, so how you will do it? Okay, so this one is used to just deny the permission. So if you want to again revert the permission, so instead of N, you have to be use the F. Okay, you just need to put the command F and then after press enter. Okay, if you go for this one, if you open again, now it's opening. Okay, so in my scenario, as you seen here in my preview, as you seen here I have two users, so I'm just going to be deny the room, this folder permission to the Rumi test only. Okay, so my command will be same command, instead of everyone it will be Rumi test, whatever username that you have. Okay, I have test, and instead of F it will be N, because I am going to be deny. Okay, so this one I am going to deny my Rumi test folder in E directory to Rumi test user. Okay, so just press enter. Okay, so if you open this one, it's open for you, but when the roomie test is logging on this PC, he's not able to get the permission on this folder. So it's a too effective in this condition. And you can also do with the graphical, but it's a too easy to do with the in this command prompt. So hope you like my videos. Please subscribe, and if you have any doubt, please feel free to comment. Thanks, bye.